dear brethren and friends. Wakeman here. The first narcissist, also known as Satan, plays with a double-edged sword because he knows how to use it. Jesus made the statement, "And if a house be divided against itself, that house cannot stand." The satanic narcissist's plan for our world is to divide and conquer. As Paul says, we are not ignorant of his devices. 2 Corinthians 2:11, and knowing of your enemy's plans is one of the crucial first steps to defeating him. We spend so much time trying to prove one side or the other that we lose sight of God's plan. Satan knows that, and as long as he has God's children distracted with stupid things, God's children drift apart. Ever heard that old saying, divide and conquer? This is the satanic narcissist establishment ultimate goal, and it is working, and has been for a very long time. Satan knows that, as long as we are focused on our arguments, then we are not focused on our relationship with God. So all of us, guided by God's Spirit, must profoundly seek God more than ever before. We must genuinely study the Word of God to gain the mind of Christ. We must meditate on the real meaning of all these issues, and fast, as we have the strength and opportunity. In every way we can, we must truly seek God's guidance and strength, as the end of this human society approaches, and as Satan becomes angrier and lashes out at God's children in every way he can. The satanic narcissist establishment is literally brainwashing millions of people, especially our children, to assume that the perverted way of life they see promoted by many of our political and religious leaders, and especially through the pervasive influence of modern media, is the new normal. For this world has become the modern Babylon, right before our eyes, and God Almighty tells us to come out of her, my people, lest you share in her sins, and lest you receive of her plagues. Revelation 18, 4. God does allow us to go through all kinds of trials and tests before we are given glory in the coming kingdom and family of God. So we all need to pray fervently for one another to endure the trials and tests that we will be suffering and to come out with the right attitude that we may become members of God's family forever. What a magnificent reward we will all have when we truly seek to have Christ's mind and fully surrender to let Christ live his life within us through the Holy Spirit in the months ahead. Galatians 2:20. May God grant that all of you, dear brethren, learn to do that. Again, let each of us pray fervently for one another, pray for God's work, and pray for Christ's kingdom to come soon to this very satanic narcissist world. God bless you. Please remember, Jesus Christ is the truth, the way, and the life.